Hola amigos! Before we begin episode numero tres of our summer song series, we want to give a quick shout out to a few members of our Patreon familia.
That's right! We want to send out a big hola to a couple of my virtual Spanish students, Milo and Linus, and their mama, Holly. Hola amigos! It's been so much fun spending time together and getting to know all of you and teach Spanish to you. Your love and support for our show means a lot to us. Hasta pronto amigos! I'll see you all really soon!
We also want to give a shout out to our amigos Evren and Aiden and their mama Danielle. Hola amigos! We actually recently tried to send you all some stickers and a postcard, but the letter was returned to us. I sent you all an email, but if you have a new address and are still interested in getting some of Vanessa's homemade Los Pollitos stickers, please let us know. We're so grateful for your love and support of our show, and we hope you all are having a great Verano.
And last but not least, we want to say hola to our amigos Lillian, Adeline, and Oliver, and also to their mama, Rebecca. Hola, amigos! We heard that your whole family is learning Spanish together, and we think it's so wonderful that we get to be a part of your Spanish learning journey. Spanish is a lifelong gift, and I'm sure that when you all are older, it's going to open up so many magical doors and opportunities for all of you. So keep up the great work, and we're so proud and honored that we can be here with you at the beginning. Muchas gracias, amigos!
And thanks to all of our Patreon familia for supporting our work with Eat Your Spanish. We really wouldn't be able to do it without your help. If you're interested in joining and receiving stickers, special worksheets, music downloads, and so much more, you can visit us at patreon.com/eatyourspanish or click on the link in every episode description. Now on with the show.
Hello friends.
Hola amigos.
How are you?
¿Cómo están?
I'm so happy.
Estoy feliz.
To be with you.
A estar contigo.
Are you hungry?
¿Tienen hambre?
To sing and play.
A cantar y jugar.
'Cause on our menu.
Porque en el menu
is Spanish today. Everybody sing.
Spinach?
No, I said Spanish.
Okay. Eat your spinach with us today.
Eat your spinach!
With Evan.
And Vanessa. Hola, amigos.
Hello, friends. Me llamo Evan. My name's Evan.
Y yo me llamo Vanessa. And my name's Vanessa. We're so excited to be with you for our third episode of the Eat Your Spanish Summer Song Series. Remember that playlist that Evan and I made for all of you and shared in the last couple of episodes? If you still haven't downloaded it yet, you still can by clicking on one of the links in today's episode description. Well, today we're going to be featuring another one of those songs. Can any of you amigos listening guess what song it is?
Let's see if you were right. Drum roll, please. Today's episode is going to be all about song numero dos in our summer song playlist, Amor de Verano, by one of our favorite bands called Vacacion, or Vacation in Spanish.
Yay, this song is so beautiful, and it's so neat that the band's name is a cognate. Vacación means vacation in Spanish, and they sound almost exactly the same. We love all the music Vacación makes. If you've listened to our podcast for a long time, you may remember this band from our Spanish Song of the Month series a while back when we talked about and translated another one of their songs called Te de Tila. The song we'll hear today is called Amor de Verano, and actually has the word summer in the title. Can any of you amigos listening guess which of these words is summer in Spanish? Amor, de, or verano? If you said verano, muy bien! The word verano means summer in Spanish. The title of this song is Summer Love, and like many of the songs on Vacacion's album, it's a love song.
So today we'll listen to the song all together once, then Vanessa will explain to us what the words mean, and then we'll listen one more time. And after that, we'll hand the program over to Mrs. Elephant and Mr. Mouse so that they can answer one of our listener questions.
All right, amigos. Are you ready to listen to Amor de Verano? Here we go.
That was great. The music in this song is so catchy and upbeat. It made me want to clap mis manos and wave mis brazos in the air, just like an Army Cuerpo song. I bet the words are really special too. Hey Ness, you want to share with us what the words mean in English?
Claro, mi amor. I would love to. And you're right, the words are really beautiful, just like the music. The first words in the song are Ya no hay nada que esconder. Junto a ti me siento bien. Which means, now there is nothing to hide. Next to you, I feel so good. Then in the rest of the first section, the words mean, toss me a wish so that I can find out what I did to deserve all that you give to me. Then the chorus of the song, or coro in Spanish, which is the part of the song that repeats lots of times, the words go like this. Solo deseo tiempo sincero y que vayamos a bailar. Which means, all I want is quality time and to go dancing with you. Isn't that so sweet? Let's keep going, amigos. In the second verse, he says, Hoy no lo puedo creer. Hueles espectacular. Amo este presente. Agradezco a tus papás. In English, he's saying how grateful he is to the parents of the person that he loves. And how this special person smells spectacular, and that he is so grateful to spend the day with them. And then we go into the chorus again, which is Solo deseo tiempo sincero, which is all I want is quality time, y que me llevas a bailar, and to go dancing with you. Then there's one more little piece of the puzzle to this song, and it comes right before the last chorus. In this part, he sings these words. Cierro los ojos, me importa poco lo que nos digan los demás, which means I close my eyes, it doesn't really matter to me what anyone else thinks. And then the chorus again. Solo deseo tiempo sincero, all I want is quality time, y que me llevas a bailar, and to go dancing with you. I love this song and these beautiful words because it really shows how special every moment feels when you're with people that you care about. I think it's a really great love song too because it can really be about any special person in our lives, like a person in our familia or a person who's special to us in a different way.
Yeah, that's a good point, Vanessa. All right, amigos, so now that we know the meaning of the song in English, are you ready to hear esta canción otra vez? Are you ready to hear this song one more time? All right, here we go.
Muchas gracias for listening to this beautiful song with us. We hope you enjoyed it as much as we do. Now that we've listened to our special Spanish song, there's only one thing left to do.
Did we make it in time?
I don't think I've ever run so fast.
Wow, Mrs. Elephant, Mr. Mouse, it's so great to see you. You made it just in time. Although it looks like you kind of accidentally ran through the wall again instead of using the door.
Oh, Whoopsie daisy, I sometimes get a little wild when I'm in a hurry. Sorry for breaking your casa. We'll cook some dumpling soup for our aunt neighbors and see if they'll swing by. They can probably fix that up in no time at all. There isn't much those sweet buddies won't do for some good home cooking.
Yeah, sorry about that, guys. Anywho, all of our amigos listening must be ready to hear from one of our special listeners.
That's right. Who is this week's special listener, Mr. Mouse?
This week's special listener is... Jax! Jax, what is your question?
My name is Jax, and I want to know how to say five-second banish.
Wow, what a fantastic question. We just heard one going by our neighborhood the other day. We were so worried, but luckily they were just testing out the sirens. It's so important to have fire trucks and firefighters. We are all so much safer because of them. Maybe we can play a fire truck sound for our amigos listening at home. You want to try it, Mr. Mouse? If any amigos out there have sensitive ears, you may want to cover them up for a second or two because the fire truck sirens can be pretty loud. Here we go, amigos. Uno, dos, tres.
Intense. I guess they have to be pretty loud. That way cars know it's time to get out of the way.
That's absolutely right, Mr. Mouse. So, my little sweet pea, how do you say fire truck in Spanish?
Oh, yeah. To say fire truck, you say camión de bomberos. Now let's try saying it all together. Camión de bomberos.
Camión de bomberos.
Camión de bomberos.
Camión de bomberos. Muy bien, amigos. I hope you don't ever see a camión de bomberos in front of your casa, but if you do, look for the bomberos or the firemen inside because they know just what to do in an emergency. And even though their outfits might be a little unusual, the people inside of them are helpers, and they're really nice too. They take big risks to protect us, so make sure if you ever do see a bombero inside of your house, to remember that they are there to help, and it's always a good idea to listen to them and let them help you.
Ooh, good point, Mrs. Elephant. Well, amigos, great work learning our new words, and thanks, Jax, for the great question. Now that we've answered, there's only one thing left to do. Sing our goodbye song.
We hope you'll sing along with us, amigos.
Adios, mi buen amigo.
Goodbye, my good friend.
Hasta luego.
See you later.
See you later, my good friend.
Adios, amigos. Goodbye, friends.
Hasta luego. See you later.
Thanks for listening to the Eat Your Spanish podcast. You can support our podcast by visiting patreon.com/eatyourspanish or by subscribing to it and leaving a review on Apple Podcasts. You can also find us on Facebook, Instagram, or on the web at eatyourspanishpodcast.com. Thanks for listening. Adios!